I think we still have another minute, right? We have another minute to go. That's fine. No problem.
Okay, we are live.
Yeah. So I think we are waiting still for Shivali. Shivali is there?
Yes, ma'am. I'm here.
Okay, fine. Okay. So I think it's another minute, and then after that we can start the debate. So hello everybody on Facebook. We're just waiting for the time to kind of hit 5:30, and then we will start with this debate session. Okay, good evening everybody. Welcome to this debate session by OCI. We just thought that everybody, you know, with all the serious education that's happening on Zoom and GoToWebinar and all the kind of platforms that you can think of, we thought we'll have something fun and involve all the youngsters as well. So welcome to the first debate session. We're going to have the career opportunity debate, hospital, working in a hospital versus working in an optical setup. So that is the debate today, and we'll have four rounds. Each round will be once the hospital will start, and then after that we'll have the optical chain debate, then again hospital, and then again optical. So like that, four rounds, each person gets 5 minutes to debate, and the rebuttal also will be for 5 minutes. We'll give an extra time of 30 seconds, and then they'll have to stop. So that's the debate. Of course, no foul language and other things to be used. And this is strictly going to be professional. Of course, a lot of light humor is definitely encouraged. So over to you, Paula.
Hello, everybody. Good evening. So as already the introduction is done, I would like to introduce today's participants. So we have Mr. Asit and Ms. Uma, who will be representing the hospital side. Can you just wave your hands, Asit and Uma? Yes. Yes. And from the optical front, we will be having Hardi and Shivali. Welcome, both of you. Okay, so the flow will be, we will start with Asit, and then the rebuttal will be by Shivali. And then again, Uma will take the charge for hospital, and then again, the rebuttal will be from Hardi. And then we will have a reverse. So you guys, I think, understood the rules. So, okay, we start then?
Yes.
All right, all the best.
Thank you.
Thank you so much.
Okay, fine. So, we'll start.
Time. Yeah, go ahead.
Okay, ma'am, you need to say time start.
Yeah, so 3, 2, 1, time starts now.
Good evening, everyone. I am Asit Tripathi from University of Uttar Pradesh University of Medical Sciences, Chennai. Currently, I am pursuing my internship from Ahuja Eye and Dental Institute, Gurugram. Today, I am participating in the debate on the side of hospital practice. So, I am not totally opposing optical practice because it's part of our profession. But it does not mean that professional optometrist completely turns out to be an optician or optical practitioner, because our definition of optometry says that we are primary eye healthcare professionals. So it will be a productive profession and goes to hospital and learn hospital practices, etc. Definition of optometry itself says that optometrists will learn all the criteria in which optical is included, but purely going to optical practice is not a justice to our profession. When we are practicing to optical areas, we are limited to refraction, but when we are practicing in hospitals, we provide comprehensive eye care services like clinical investigations, diagnosis, binocular vision, contact lens practice, vision therapies, prosthetics, neuro rehabilitation, investigations, diagnosis, counseling, etc. When we are practicing in hospital, as a hospital optometry practitioner, we provide multiple role of our optometry services, and that is the way of doing ethical optometry practice which we are holding and which is very important and necessary for a comprehensive eye care examination. In hospital teaches you about counseling the patient. That is most important part of our practice. It gives you, and when you are practicing in hospital, most of patients come in hospital for regular eye checkup, and you do it well then. Then patient gives you lot of blessings and wishes, good wishes. And in hospital teaches you about clinical optometry, which you can't gain from optical side. OT experience in hospital in training introduced. OT experience in hospital training gives you good referral system and teaches you about counseling, which is very important in our optometry practice. Ethical practices in hospital gives you lots of respect and blessings. Hospital teaches you how to counsel the patient. Hello, am I audible?
Yes, you are.
When we are practicing in hospital, we are doing many rural camps, because in our Indian population, 60 to 65% of Indian population live in rural areas. And in hospital practice, we are going in multiple camps in rural areas for prevention of blindness, which is very important, which is very important role as a primary eye healthcare practitioner for us. And I think it's okay from my side.
Okay, so he is finished before 5 minutes. It was 3 minutes and 50 seconds. Paula, you are muted.
Okay, so I will summarize a few points before Shivali starts. So Asit has specifically mentioned that optometrists are primary eye care professionals. In hospitals, they learn more of clinical optometry, they learn more of counseling skills, and also serve the rural population through eye camps. So these are the main points which he has raised. So Shivali will rebuttal.
Shivali, your time starts now.
Yes. Start. First of all, very good evening to everybody. So I totally agree with Mr. Asit, as he has mentioned that we all are optometrists. So we do respect and we do are proud of that. First thing, that is the foremost thing I would like to conclude here. And the second thing I would like to appreciate him about is, yes, when you are in a clinical practice, you are giving hopes to someone. You are giving vision to someone, and that is the foremost and primary care what we have. But I contradict him on very points that he concluded about optical, and I would like to highlight a few points over here. So first of all, optical doesn't only deal with your refraction, but is also is dealt with dispensing. So I would like to highlight here this. Dispensing is also very much important while you are providing vision to someone. You are prescribing a number to someone. I'm giving a live example here. I have prescribed a number to someone. The person has got a higher power. He is a high myopic. And he is wearing the spectacles for the very first time. So in hospital criteria, what you do is you just get a number and the person goes for the periodontal consultation. And then optical chain is linked there. They come to an optical and get their product made there. So an optometrist is foremost of importance there also. Why? Because we make him understand that how he or she is going to use the spectacles, how he or she is going to take care of the same, and how he or she is going to have the benefits of the products that we are providing them. First, we are touching their health criteria there, as you mentioned, that we are health professionals, first thing. And second thing, we are also touching their cosmetical appearance. For a little kid, wearing his spectacles for the first time, it's a big hassle. He feels like, what is this? Why am I wearing this? I will not wear this. But at that point of time, if we give him something very attractive and trendy, he will like to endorse that. So we plant a seed endorsement to the beings that spectacle is not a taboo or recommend you, but yes, it is for your betterment of your vision. So this was the conclusion that I wanted to keep, wanted to say from Asit. And here are the points I want to highlight also. So it is very true that optometrist is a wholesome of very many things. First of all, we are there for diagnostic procedures. That is only regarding our our hospital setup. And secondly, we are foremost importantly there for other procedures as well, as you mentioned, vision therapy, etc. So we do have an exposure of the same things in optical as well. First thing, I would say it is totally depending on you where you are going. So what lane you are choosing, what company you are working with also plays a role that how much a drive they are giving you to make, how much drive they are giving you to give to the customer, how much experience they are providing you to give them. For example, if a person comes into an optical, if I am the only person there as an optometrist and also as a private consultant, because we have mixture of people in an optical. So if I am the one who is playing role of private consultant, of your lens counselor, and also as a health practitioner, I'm giving them the bestest refraction there. My work is done there. I am there for them, and I'll also play a very important role in their life because I have given them something which they are going to use at least for 1 year, because we are Indian population. We don't leave anything unless that picks up. So that is what I would like to highlight. My philosophy of getting into optical is only one thing. I want to influence people's mind. So this influence, I get drive from optical only. Yes, Asit was very much correct and having the upper hand on the point that we are also giving a lot of hopes to people with vision therapy, with prosthetics. Prosthetics is one of the worshipping a thing I would say that we have in optometry, because we are literally playing the role of a god here when we
time
are
up,
providing.
Time up.
Sure, thank you.
All right. So Shivali, your rebuttal were on the point that in an optical, a person when a person comes with a prescription, an optometrist plays a role of a health consultant as well as a lens consultant. As a consultant, basically, and makes them learn the use of spectacle, how to take care of them. And you have put more emphasis on that, how an optometrist in an optical setup influences the life of a patient or a client or a customer. So your points were those. So now we'll come to Uma. Uma will rebuttal.
Hi, good evening everyone. So I'll talk few points from the hospital side based like practice. So as Ashit said, that there is a definition which is posed by World Council of Optometry itself, says we are primary healthcare practitioners and we provide comprehensive eye care, which includes many things like refraction, as Shivali said, the dispensing part is very important, and there is a detection, diagnosis and management and disease of the eyes, and we also rehabilitate and counsel the patients or the customer, whatever we want to call them. So in this time, in this definition itself, it exposes the word that the dispensing and the refraction is just the part of our optometry field. It is not only that refraction and dispensing we are going to do, But in optical outlet or optical setup, mainly they are focused into dispensing and the refraction part. And for example, suppose the person is coming into an hospital or clinic, he is expecting that I want to do my routine examination. So he doesn't think that only I have to check my refraction, only I have to do my number checkup. So no, it's not like that. वो ये नहीं बोलते कि मुझे सिर्फ number दे दो. They sometimes say that मुझे routine examination करना. I want to check my eyes. So उस time में we also do the refraction. Obviously our primary goal is that we have to first do the refraction and dispense this all. Then we just check also the anterior part, the posterior part, and the fundus, and we have to find whether the conjunctiva, cornea, all the things are fine. So not only a patient coming for routine examination says that I want to just check my number. Yeah, it's the primary goal. We have to check the number. So I want to say that the refraction is only one component. The whole optometry doesn't mean the refraction and dispensing. So in optical, according to me, they are mainly focused into this dispensing and refraction. And in pre-surgical procedure, as we know, there are many preventable blindness going throughout the world. So if the doctor is planning for surgery. So in hospital setup, the equipments are easily available that we can do all the procedures before only. But in optical outlet, we can see that there is some limited equipment available. But in the hospital setup, there are easily available equipment where we can reduce the time limit of patient. For example, if the patient is going for routine examination and in the optical outlet, as Shivali said, there is a senior optometrist, trained optometrist sitting there. He knows that the patient is having some pathology. Then he refers that, sir, please, you have to take the appointment for hospital and you will go to hospital. The patient might be taken holiday from his office and came to you for refraction power, and you are concerned, and you are like optometrist, you are saying there is some pathology after seeing your refraction power. So you will send him to the hospital where you have to take in, specifically in this condition, in this era, in hospitals they are taking the appointments and they are sending the patient. So patient have to also put one more holiday to go to hospital. So here we can limit the time limit of the patient. The patient directly comes, walks into hospital, we see his refraction, we say that yeah, you have this pathological. As soon as we refer to the particular doctor or the specialty or further evaluation, we do. Am I audible?
Yes.
Yeah. So, and also in optical outlet, there is no binocular workup or orthoptic workup is done. But in hospital, we have this equipment, this binocular instruments that as soon as we see the patient is having mesotropia, rather than prescribing the prisms or diplopia, we start the orthoptic workup that whether it can be improved without glasses or prisms, we can do, we can improve with these exercises. So it all is available easily in the hospital. As nowadays, the near work is more due to this pandemic. So we know that the refractive error is going to obviously come to the patient eye. But at the same condition, there might be the DES, that is digital eye strain. We can cure, we can help it out with some exercises routinely we can do. So in clinic, the optometrist is trained to explain to the patient, not only varying the refraction. Obviously, as Shivali said, that we used to train the patient for how to use the spectacle, how to keep your glasses very precautious. At that same condition, it is also important to counsel the patient how you have to do your exercises, how the glasses is going to surely help you, but there are some other components also about the eyes which is going to help you more enhance your vision and bright and sharp vision and all. And in the children, obviously the color vision is most important as they are going outside and using the books, plates. And in optical outlet, I think not color vision is done in the children's and all. And for diagnosis is the very important part. I don't think so. In optical outlet, they have this fundus photography for doing that.
Time up.
Okay. Okay, ma'am.
You'll get your chance, Uma.
Okay,
according to Uma, again, comprehensive eye examination was one which was already discussed by Asit, and the one point which she emphasized is availability of more resources in hospital than in an optical setup. So, okay, now Hardi, you will rebuttal.
Yeah. So, a very good evening to everybody. Okay, so Uma said there are many resources available in clinic. I totally agree with her. There are. But what about the diagnosis point? I would like to reflect here that main role of an optometrist is not the diagnosis. Anyway, if you work in a clinical setup, if even if you diagnose, it is on your own. But again, under you are under someone else. There is someone superior to you who is going to tell you the final diagnosis as well as he is going to deal with the patients, right? Whereas in optical, we are the major person, right? And we are the ones who need to take the decisions, what kind of management we have to give it to the patient, whether it is a spectacle or a contact lens or any other. Second thing, based on color vision, as Uma said, definitely you can diagnose whether a patient has a color vision problem or not. But in every optical setup, along with the chair unit and along with the drum, vision drum, there comes red and green, if you all know, right? So basic test, like basic way to diagnose if a patient may be having a color vision problem or not is with that. Another thing is, even if the optometrist is in optical setup and the patient has already went to doctor and he knows he got all the diagnosis done and all the problems done, but what if when he goes to the optical, you are the ones, okay, digital screens, for example, if digital screen devices uses much more and you just suggest patient to go for blue block lenses, but what kind of blue block lenses? What should be actually dispensed to the patient or customer is what we do in optical setup. We give him the product knowledge and we are the ones who we have to take the decision for them. No, sir, not this particular, because there are many, many kinds of products available in market. Everybody is aware of it. But what is particularly favorable for that patient is has to be that decision has to be taken by us. Another thing, Ashit said that in a clinical setup, camps are possible. I work in an optical sector and I can proudly say that we have undergone all these operations. We have also arranged many camps for the patients, for the basic eye test, for the refraction. And wherever it was necessary, we have suggested them to go to the ophthalms. If the, I mean, everybody can, we are allowed to do the torchlight examination. And with that torchlight examination, at least basic diagnosis can be done by us so that we can refer them to the doctor, right? So that is the part is which is done by us. So it is not a thing that camps can only be done in clinical setup. This is my point. Again, refraction. Okay, so refraction is the main point for us. Second is use of instruments. Coming to instruments, not every clinic has lensometer. Not every clinic has allows retinoscopy or whatever, but optical setup is one thing that allows you to practice your retinoscopy and every other technique that you have. Second thing is they are flexible with everything. Decision making is first what I said. Second, how to improve or how well to means whatever the business is going on, whatever the market is, along with that, how we can grow. I mean, they motivate you to present your ideas in front of others, right? So that is another point where we get opportunities. Then second is rehab and management. Yes, definitely we can provide. But at the end, even if you are in clinical setup, again, you are under someone else, right? And it is the ophthal who gives the final management, whether you have to go with the low vision aids or the contact lens aid or anything else. We are the ones who at the end have to provide it. So we don't have a command there, but we need to do what the superior person is telling us. Whether in optical, again, if the patient has to go for RGP lenses or soft lenses or anything else, we are the ones to decide, we have to give them or not. So that is what I wanted to share. And in addition to that, even if the patient has some internal eye problem and he comes with all those files, there are many patients that come to the optical store with all the files that we have this retinal problem, we have that problem. So again, if there is no optometrist in their optical shop, he won't have a knowledge of whatever it's written in.
Time up.
Okay.
You can finish, Hardi.
Yeah. So again, he doesn't have an idea, but we, being an optometrist, we have seen all the conditions during our internship, during our 4 years of optometric practice or studies even. So at least we can guide him properly to whatever is suitable and whatever it is available.
Time up. Time up.
Again, I can even continue because it has to start with me.
Yes. We'll give you a breather. Don't worry.
Yeah. So you want to summarize first?
Yes, I'll summarize. Yeah. So, okay. So Hardi has emphasized more on an optometrist. When an optometrist is present in an optical setup, the optometrist has the independence of, you know, taking the decision and expressing ideas and solely taking decisions. That was her main emphasis. And also she has countered Asit on CAMS, that only hospital-based practice or an optometrist in hospital only doesn't do CAMS. Optometrists in optical setups also go for CAMS and the referral system. Again, if an optometrist in an optical finds out that this pathology is there or something other than refraction is the refractive error is there, they are equipped to refer that patient. So these were her points. So over to you.
जबरदस्त पहला राउंड हुआ है
एकदम.
यस सो दिस इज ग्रेट टू सी द गुड रीबटल्स. सो व्हाट एवर आशित सेड आई थिंक शिवाली रीबटेड एंड इवन हार्दी एंड उमा इज ब्रॉट आउट वेरी गुड पॉइंट्स इन टर्म्स ऑफ यू नो टाइम सेविंग फॉर रेफरल्स. दे नीड गो फ्रॉम वन प्लेस टू द अदर. एंड देन हार्दी सेड कैंप्स आर ऑल्सो पॉसिबल इन ऑप्टिकल सेटअप. So great going. I think we'll start the second round in the reverse order. So I think Hardi will start first, correct?
Yes.
So over to you. Continue, yes.
So my time starts?
Yes.
Okay. Yeah. So again, I want to reflect on one more point about blessings, wishes, and respect. Again, a point put up by Ashit, right? So in optical setup, like day and night you socialize more and more because you interact with more and more customers. You need to first analyze how you need to deal with the customer, how you need to present yourself. And the thing, when a customer is actually convinced by you, they actually come to know that, yeah, you are an optometrist, you are a primary eye healthcare practitioner. They gain a belief that, yes, we can go to optical shops, we can get good guidance from there also. So after knowing all these, there are many customers who give us blessings, who give us respect, and even they are surprised to know that there is such kind of thing like optometry field. Usually whenever I speak to my relatives and I say that I'm an optometrist, okay, so you are an eye doctor and you'll do all the surgery and everything. And as soon as I say, no, I won't be able to do surgery, but pre and post surgical tests are performed by me. So first and the foremost thing they used to say is, achha, phir to chashme ki dukaan hi kholegi aur to kya. But least they know that it is not only about an chashme ki dukan, but there are many other things which we can provide them. So that is the main point. And when they come to know all these things, they are the ones, oh wow, really, this is something new for them. And so yeah, in that way we also get respect, we get blessings, we get wishes. In fact, until now, I have, like, in my experience, I have come across some customers who came from they had their eye test done with at some hospital, and they came here, and we sometimes recheck their power if it matches or not. And there have been many cases where the power we checked at our optical setup was better accepted by the ones they got from the hospital setup. So that is one thing that I wanted to say. Another contact lens practice, yes. It can be provided at both the places, no doubt, but what all things are available in market, what all companies are there, what are the materials, all that knowledge is necessary. It can't be given in a hospital setup because already for the entire eye checkup, being internal and external, it takes least 20 minutes. So nobody can, like, after even providing them management ideas, you can't explain them, like, go for this thing or go for that thing. That is what is done at the optical setup. And those are the things. But at the end, being an optometrist, I don't go totally against the clinical setup. Of course, we need that also. It is most important because at the end, our aim is vision, health, and care for the patient. So yeah, that is all I wanted to say. I'm not totally against of it, but these are the points that that people miss within the optical setup. Yeah.
Okay.
I'm done.
3 minutes, 40 seconds.
Okay. So in this round, Hardi has mentioned that how an optometrist in an optical setup, touches the life or maybe changes the perception of people ki yahan chashme ki dukan hai, but then when a person visits and gets the feel, so that perception gets changed. So that is how an optometrist touches the lives of people. Then she has also mentioned about knowledge of products to the patient or the customer or the client, and how an optometrist in an optical setup can spend quality time or give that quality time to the patient rather than in an hospital setup. So these are the points which she has mentioned. So Uma, you'll rebuttal?
Yes, ma'am, sure. So to rebuttal, I totally agree with Hardi that we are independent practitioner. I totally agree. But taking help or seeking help from other person, like whether it is our senior optometrist, whether it is our optas, it's like no bad thing from it. They are guiding us. They are going to do better work and they are going to enhance the patient. However, we want is the patient should be comfortable and happy. So they are giving us help only. So there is nothing bad to take help from, though we are independent practitioner. And you also mentioned that in the optical outlet, there is a green duochrome present in the table. I totally agree. But when the children sits on the table, he is quite nervous that the person is going to do something with my eyes. So he or she won't tell you the proper thing that the red is green. Maybe due to nervousness, he won't tell that he got confused. So at that time, we have some specific screening books or some books are there. We specifically ask which are regarding shape. The children are also quite happy and they play with it. There are some techniques to measure the color vision in the clinic also. And I totally agree. The optical people do the cams. Even I have so many. But somehow their intention is to market the optical outlet and to... Somehow they have these frames. We have to sell our frames. We have to do something. We have to somehow market our optical outlet. So one of the, I'm not saying they're purposely doing for that. Somehow one of the important thing is that they have to do the marketing thing also. But in a hospital outlet, we are not doing any marketing. We are really concerned about, though as an optometrist, you are concerned about the patient life, but somehow your owner or the person who is having this optical outlet, he is having that back idea that I want to market my optical outlet and I want to sell these frames. Next time the patient will come to me if I am giving low cost of frame now. So somehow they have the idea of marketing. One of I think according to me, and I have saw it. And as you said, there you people have the retinoscopes and also the lensometer. As an optometrist, the day is upgrading. I totally agree. We have automatic AR or automatic lensometer, but still in many, some of clinics don't have this retinoscope and lensometer, but mostly the clinics which are running from optometry side or the proper ethical practice who are doing this, surely they will have this retinoscope and manual lensometer, and surely they will do that. And many and as you said, that respect they also give from us. I think respect giving is everyone gives each other, but the right respect is important. You have to identify yourself. The patient has to know that this is optometrist. She has done my work. I have to respect as an optometrist. Because many of people, when they come to the optical outlet, they think, yeah, ki mereko bhi chashma banana hai, toh main chashma wale ke dukaan mein jaunga. They see you as an optician only. Whether you are optometrist or optal, they don't No, they see you as an optician only. Though they are respecting, I'm not saying that opticians should not respect. Yeah, they should respect, but right respect should be given to everyone. As an eye optometrist, I expect that I should be respected as an optometrist. And you said that while fitting the contact lens, I agree with you, you have many knowledge in optical, the companies, what are the base curves available and all. But if the patient is having post contact lens that he has or she has didn't maintain, though you educated the patient, he is not getting it and he had some infection, and surely you will refer to hospital only at that moment. You have to refer to the hospital only. Huh? The patient is having some infection or the post contact lens, something went wrong. So we have to send it to the hospital only. And to conclude, I won't say that the optometry is the optical outlet is our part. So I think optometry and optical hospital practice and optical outlet should go hands on end. But like in many hospital, you see that they have optical outset store outside their hospital or clinic, but every optical doesn't have backside the clinic. So that is one of the point. And whenever you go to optical outlet, you can see that there may be optometrist and there may be optician, but in hospital, you never see there is optician sitting in your room and doing the refraction part, or he's trying to diagnose things and all. So I think right place, right respect should be given. And that's it. Or just a second. Yeah. Point I missed in my first round, that if the patient is having the central vision, there are many conditions. Though you have very expertise as an optical outlet working, you expertise in refraction, and you say by seeing refraction, you say that the patient is having this diagnosis. But no, sometimes there are some diseases in which the peripheral vision are affected. At that condition, the I'm 30 seconds.
Okay. Yes. Go on. Finish it.
So at that condition, like glaucoma, the peripheral vision is affected. So at that condition, by only seeing the near central vision, you can't prescribe the refraction. Somehow after some years or decades, the person is going to be affected. But in hospital, we do confrontation tests and many additional tests where we can early diagnose the condition and start to manage or start to treat those conditions.
Time up.
Okay. Oh, what a fight. Okay, so Uma has mentioned that yes, there's nothing wrong in getting guidance from a senior, yes. And she has also rebutted and said that opticals, they have more of a sales perspective, though it is like they're going to camps, as Hardi said. But then the sales perspective is more, and of course, she has also mentioned that the right respect should be given to the right person. Sometimes it might be happening that in an optical setup, you never know, an optician who is not maybe a qualified person is trying to, you know, give guidance or trying to, you know, do the diagnosis and stuff. So this, she has mentioned this point as well. So, okay. Okay, we'll go to Shivali. Okay. So Shivali will rebuttal.
Okay. So I agree with Uma on some points, but I don't agree wholly solely. So I would like to counter attack on the first thing, that is respect. So the first thing I would say, whosoever you are, whatever profession you are in, it doesn't matter what you are, unless and until you come there and you introduce yourself. So in optical, the person enters. The person is your, it is you who is going to take the time out. If you want to keep him for 1 hour, you are there. You can keep him for 1 hour. You can counsel him for 1 hour. You can talk to him for 1 hour. So in that 1 hour, what first thing you are going to tell him is that you are an optometrist. So there we give them awareness. So there is a time span for optometrist in hospital. Setup. There you get time limitations there. So I think and I suppose that time limitation brings you accuracy first thing with your practice, but you don't have that leisure time to introduce yourself, to give weightage to your profession, where we are lagging somewhere in the awareness part that you mentioned, that we don't have awareness about that. Kya koi optometrist hota hai? Kaun hota hai? people doesn't even know how to pronounce that. I have such people coming and asking, "What? Who are you?" So I take a point here that I am an optometrist, and yes, I am available for these things. So there I can connect with that. So second thing I would like to touch is about marketing. So yes, we do market, and we are proud of that we are marketing the right product, not the wrong product. Some people are there, like you were showing me a difference between opticians and optometrists, as you said earlier. So opticians, correct. They are far much different from us. We are optometrists. So we are responsible, and we proudly take that responsibility of marketing the right product to right customers. So here I come with the rightfulness that we talk about. If I suppose we all dispense progressives and we all suggest progressive also, but every person who is having near vision, who is getting into category of presbyopia, doesn't need a progressive. So that differentiation should be made by an optometrist who is either or an optician. So, and also marketing is also done in hospitals when you put IOLs and everything, and at the time of the screening also. And yes, also, I would like to add up one more point with the things that we heard in the first round, that was about CAM. I missed that point. So we do CAMs also. There are optical chains that promote this also. But also, we also have one plus point. What is that? It is that we have that a patient is coming in. A patient straight away don't go to a hospital unless and until he is having the need of going there. There should be a need generation for the customer or the patient to come to a hospital setup. Pehli cheez kya? Market mein jayenge. वहां देखेंगे वहां पहले सजेशन लेते हैं देखो. सो इन अ वे वी आर आल्सो प्रोवाइडिंग अ सर्विस फॉर हॉस्पिटल. वी आर रेफरिंग पेशेंट्स टू द हॉस्पिटल्स. सो दिस इज आल्सो अ पॉइंट वेयर वी आर प्लेइंग अ रोल ऑफ अ मॉडरेटर. वी ऑल मस्ट हैव स्टडीड दैट वी हैव दैट मॉडल ऑफ LVPI वेयर वी गो स्टेप बाय स्टेप. वी टेक प्राइमरी टर्शियरी एंड देयर इज which should be followed for the eye examination, for eye health, eye care health. So there we are also playing the role of the first line of defense for a patient or for a customer, whatever need they have came to us for in the optical. So there I would like to add one more point, that is we have a high scope of innovation. If I think that this thing should be molded to something else. For example, I am suggesting to free to someone. If I think that these face shades should be included, the nose bridges should be included, this innovation can be done in that. So we have that high scope of innovation quality in that. And for most and the best part I also like about optical is the hierarchy system. I am an optometrist here. I got appointed in optical. I have a scope of getting to the management because there are
30 seconds left.
And there are setups and there are places in opticals where an optometrist also plays the roles of a manager. So we are doubled with the designation and we are doubled in the multitasking. So we are able to groom ourselves and handle ourselves more well. And in accordance to the eye care, we are also there are also companies in India which are providing whole comprehensive eye health checkups also. And for
time up
in case of sure.
Okay, fine. So so Shivali has said that yes. So when an optometrist guides, then the right product is being said or dispensed. That is one. And then yes, about growth and multitasking, when an optometrist works in an optical setup, because of an hierarchy, they have a growth perspective or a scope of growth to the higher level, a managerial level. Yes, she has also spoken about innovation, wherein she has said that again, that decision-making thing that, okay, this product is good or that product is good or some innovation is required with a spectacle or a contact lens or something. So these are the points which Shivali has rebutted, and Ashit will now counter her.
So as Hardeep said, that when a patient comes, it's not that when a patient comes, it's that when a customer comes, when you already think that the when a person is coming, that is customer, not a patient, then you just trying to sell your product to the customer. That is not the way of good ethical practice. When you think that is patient, not a customer, then you are doing the best for suggesting them. If you are already thinking then that is customer, you are trying to sell your product. And the second, contact lens practice and counseling. Yes, in hospitals, that is best contact lens practice and counseling available. At my hospital, Gurgaon, contact lens practice is better, and we can prescribe all the contact lenses, rose K, soft contact lenses, RGPs, etc. And all companies' contact lenses are available in one hospital. Because in opticals, we are suggesting only in one company contact lens. Just like if you have stock of some contact lenses company, then you are suggesting to patient to take this. But in hospitals, we doing ethical practice. We are not suggesting then you are taking this only. We are suggesting the need according to patient need. See what is the important things, what is the best for patient. And updating of contact lenses, yes. In hospitals, contact lens materials updation is all available, because all companies are come to hospitals for our product selling. And as a practitioner, we have right to decide what is the best for the patient, not like we are deciding for the customer. We are deciding for the patient. And independent practitioner, yes, we also have rights, and we also have independent for selling, for prescribing contact lenses and for refraction. If the patient is coming and he said, I have some problems in refraction, and we are refracting it, but we are missing some points, then we go, the patient goes to our seniors and he is checking them. That is not the problem for us. Because it is good for us. Because when we are doing a mistake there in their hospital, our seniors and senior optoms and optels are available to correct that mistake. That is not for us ki hamare liye ye dikkat nahi hai. Or when we are going in camp, we also counsel the patients, and we also suggesting them you can refer to hospital. And in hospitals, many hospitals provide free cataract operations, etc., and free IPR services, which is not providing by optical, which is also important.
You're muted, Asit. You're muted. Yeah, now it's okay. Please talk, Asit.
Yes. As we said that in hospital, we are doing ethical practice. And in ethical practice, we are suggesting the patient to best for him. We are not assuming that the patient is customer. So that is the main difference we are doing in optical practice and we are in hospitals. In hospitals, we do the proper eye check up for a patient and refer to the specialty doctor for him, and that is time consuming for us. When a patient come in optical and he is optical optometrist referred to the hospital, then that is the time consuming process. But in hospital, the patient come to us and we referring to the doctor, then that is also easy for the patient and is saving his time, his money also.
Okay,
So, I would like to say something.
Almost 5 minutes. Yes, Adi, I know where you're coming from. just hold on to your comment. Yes, Paula, you summarize and then after that we'll get the comment.
Okay, so customer versus patient, this is age old.
Correct.
Fine and ethical versus unethical, this is also age old. Okay, so majorly Asit has touched these points as in customer versus patient, and he has emphasized that in hospital mode of ethical practice happens. And also again, he has emphasized on the time saving, that if a patient comes with one problem, then if at all he has other problems, then in one go, he'll be, you know, able to settle down in the hospital with the referral system. So that is what Asit has said. Okay, Hardi has some points to establish. Okay, Hardi.
Yeah. So talking about ethics, ethics is not defined by how you term a person that
Okay. Let's stop there. Okay. So this was that point.
Okay, ma'am. I want to add one point. As Shivali said, that we are multitasked. Like we get more opportunities than a hospital. But somehow in a hospital setup also it's happening. Now we are dealing with optals, and whenever you get sharp and the optal starts to believe on you, he totally leaves on you. Whether he's whether due to personal reason, and he says, he will call you up, madam, do this, I'll come and I'll check, or do WhatsApp and send me a final decision, I will say. So somehow we are also learning from other, like, we are also having these multitasks, and also that is all. So the same thing happening in the optical setup.
Point taken. Shivali, let me summarize, okay? All optimal. Sure. Be it optical, be it private practice, be it hospital, all of us multitask, okay? And I think all of us do ethical practice. A couple of things that I found very interesting, okay? One is contact lens complications. Uma, if we had so many contact lens complications, then contact lens industry will close. Okay.
So sometimes that's why I mentioned the patient education is important. Whether you educated, some of patient doesn't follow that.
Yes, very few. But then if you're doing a good job, and contact lens is the optometry forte, if all of us do our good jobs well, then I think we'll have less and less of complications and more people wearing contact lenses rather
than talk about
complications. So that was one I found very interesting. Second thing was about diagnostics. Asit was saying, you know, you do only refraction and stuff like that. And even Uma was pointing out, well, there are a lot of private practices that do fundus examination also, Uma. So, you know, it need not be a fundus camera, but as long as you see the retina and make sure that you do a comprehensive eye exam and the prescribed spectacles, I think that is absolutely fine. So, you know, it's not that people don't do comprehensive eye exam in an optical setup and only hospitals do comprehensive eye exam. I thought that was another interesting point that I wanted to, you know, allude to. And this customer patient thing debate never ends. Okay, that debate keeps going on. Yes, Paula.
Okay, I have something to add because I am like most of my career has been into opticals. So I have learned something from a very learned person that whoever comes to buy a service is a customer. So there's no harm in, you know, calling someone a customer. कोई स्वस्थ आदमी को जो सिर्फ जिसको रिफ्रैक्टिव एरर है उसको पेशेंट बना दोगे तो वो डर जाएगा शायद. तो देयर
एग्जैक्टली
वेज ऑफ सेइंग, आप पेशेंट बोलो, क्लाइंट बोलो, कस्टमर बोलो, देयर नो दैट आई डोंट थिंक दैट बिकॉज़ दे अल्टीमेटली कम टू बाय अ सर्विस. सो दैट इज माय एक्सप्लेनेशन. उसमें कुछ गलत है.
Ma'am, to counter that also, whenever the patient comes into clinic and like unfortunately you call them customers, they also get like, we are not customer, hum aank check karane aaye, hamare aank ka takleef bataiye. So at that time the patient is also expecting to be like
customers are aaye hain aise.
No, sometimes like we also discuss with the reception customer, they get like nahi hum customer nahi, hum eye check karne aaye. So they also think that whenever I go to hospital, they should call me as a patient. And if I'm going to optical outlet or whatever they call that, chashme ki dukan, so they are so think that I should be called as a customer at that point. If you, as you said, if the patient is coming with refractive error and you say the patient, they said like, main patient nahi hu, main chashma banane aaya. So it's like, it's from the side of patient mindset only. Doesn't matter whatever we are calling them, we are doing our work.
Exactly,
yeah,
that is my point.
Calling, yeah, we are doing our work. It depends on the patient mindset, what he wants to be called or what he is thinking he wants to be called. So,
yes, and yes, Shivali, go ahead.
We aim on providing services and not terms to person, if it is a customer or patient.
Yeah,
it depends how we provide and what all services we provide.
Yeah.
Them.
Yes. So here I would like to conclude on the optical side is that customer or patient na kahin pe decided nahi aap kisko kya bulayenge. Ek insaan ko acha tabhi lagega jab aap uske naam se use bulayenge. Aap patient ko bhi naam se hi call karte ho, patient nahi kehte ho. For most thing is that just the optical ya fir just the place mein wo ghus raha hai, he is entering somewhere, jo wo chah raha hai uski need generation complete ho jaye, that is what we are.
Absolutely, yeah. I think that's a very, very, very valid point. Absolutely agreed. And I think ethical practices doesn't mean optical practices are unethical, please. Okay.
And ma'am, to the last point to be added, sorry for that, but the last point to be added, like the main reason till now we know as an optometry, and Harvey said that, yeah, in my family also some people don't know what is optometry means. Same happens with me. So somehow if I'm working in an optical outlet, they are expected to me as an optician only. So somehow in this confusion, we are proud. I agree that many of people who work in optical outlet, they are proud that they are dispensing the spectacles and all. But the confusion occurs that itself, that hum as an optometrist, I'm working in optical outlet, they think to be that she is optician only. So
that is your fault. That is your fault because you don't explain to the patient, introduce yourself and explain who you are. So the fault lies in optometrists who don't do it. And it's, I don't think it's...
Yeah, that's why we are like still struggling with our identity.
Yes.
That is the biggest challenge today, right? We need to be recognized as optometrists. Uh-huh. And what is the better platform than this? When you actually tell people, when you come in their contact and when you actually explain them what is optometry.
Absolutely. Yeah. Yes.
So this is totally our chance. Yes. And optometry future depends on us, right? How we are going to represent it.
Yeah.
Totally
agree.
This is the time we can do that.
I would like to conclude one more thing.
Last comment, Shivali. Yes.
Yes, not a comment, but yes. An optometrist can't drive a whole hospital, but an optometrist can.
I think she was trying to say that we can be independent practitioners and have our own setup. So yes, I think see both have to coexist, hospital practices as well as optical and private practices as well. Yes. So I see from whatever I've seen, this is my personal comment, and from whatever young people experience, they kind of are in hospitals for a certain amount of time until they get enough clinical knowledge, and then they move on to either working in optical chains or they open their own practices. So which means you need the hospital setup to get your clinical training, and then you open your own private practices. So as long as many private practices can be opened by optometry, that's when optometry, I think, will get this recognition also. And optical chains also have their own, advantages as well, where I think you get to learn how to market certain products and dispensing, good dispensing and all of that. So both have to go hand in hand. You can't just have clinical and say, I don't have any knowledge about dispensing. You need to know about dispensing as well. So absolutely well done, guys. Great teamwork. Excellent points that came out. Great discussion also on Facebook, which I was tracking. I think everybody who's viewing this has enjoyed it thoroughly. So thanks for taking your time and, talking about optometry. And I could see the energy in all the four of you. So yes, keep this energy And it's really great to see youngsters with that energy for the profession. So as long as you guys have the energy for the profession, for the right reasons, ethical practice, wherever you're working, be it optical, private practice or hospital, I think the profession will definitely grow 100-fold. So thanks a lot. I would like to say that and summarize today's. So thanks for participating and I hope everybody enjoyed this as well.
Thank you so much for having us.
Thank you so much.
Thank you so much, ma'am.
Thank you. Thanks, Paula.
Thank you.